I'm going to make an assumption and then a wild generalization, and maybe you can comment critically on both. The assumption is that with the price of airline tickets, a growing middle class, that medical tourism in the next few decades, if anything, is going to continue, going to increase wildly, drastically. The wild assumption or generalization has to do with something that keeps coming up today, that discrepancy between what nations allow internally and what they seem to tolerate when its citizens go overboard. The wild speculation is over time, over the next few decades, with the increase in medical tourism, that discrepancy will tend gradually to diminish.
So very interesting. So let me first just talk about the assumption for a moment. In the US, I think the market is changing dramatically, in part because of the Affordable Care Act. We'll see what the Supreme Court thinks next week when they have oral arguments. But if the Affordable Care Act is here to stay, currently most people who go abroad for medical tourism are uninsured or underinsured. That means they have insurance, but for whatever reason, the deductible, the copay, or whatever, dissuades them from consuming here. I think actually, if the Affordable Care Act gets implemented correctly and continues, the uninsured population is going to diminish. The underinsured, unclear what's going to happen, probably also will diminish. But we're seeing increasing interest by insurance companies of involving this. And by the way, undocumented aliens are the one group left out of the subsidies of the exchanges and the like in terms of getting more affordable health care in the US. So we'll still see a lot of flow, particularly along the Mexican border, for people going home to their country of ethnic origin for health care. Elsewhere in the world, though, I think you're completely right that the chances are, as airline tickets become cheaper, as telecommunication, as health IT, among other things, gets better and we have more interoperability, the ability to run medical tourism as a way of providing always is going to be, it's not going to be emergency care. That will always be provided in the locality. But we'll see more and more elective surgeries, I think, in that direction. In terms of the speculation about whether we will see more or less convergence on the norms question, I think on the question of technical, like, for example, the best way to do a particular procedure, I think we are likely to get more convergence because we're going to have more sharing, more experience, and the like. On these more moral questions about abortion and assisted suicide, for example, my own view is that the easier medical tourism becomes, actually the less pressure countries will face to converge. And we'll live with the way Ireland has lived for the last little while, which is we keep our abortion law the way it is, and you just go somewhere else if you want to have an abortion. So my own intuition is actually on the moral questions, it may go in the opposite direction. But mine, too, is rank speculation, so we're going to have to see.
Robert?
I would just say that I think medical tourism is here to stay, I think, because you also have a widening gap between wealth in the world, between countries that are wealthy and not. And so for a lot of procedures, there'll still be a difference. Take, for example, assisted reproductive technologies. If I want a womb to carry my child, in the US that costs about $100,000. In India it costs maybe $5,000. And that is not going away, partly because if there are procedures like that that the Affordable Care Act undoubtedly will not cover because they're not considered essential. If I am a single woman, a single man, a gay couple, a lesbian couple, or I just can't conceive because I'm 40 and I was fertile when I was 30, but now I decide to have a career and I'm 40, the Affordable Care Act won't cover for me to get as much assisted reproductive technology as I want. It's $100,000 plus, and there are places it'll be cheaper and that's going to stay. Convergence, I think, unfortunately, the world is a complex place, and that even in Europe, to buy and sell human body parts is illegal in all of Western Europe. There are only three countries, as I understand it, where it's explicitly allowed to buy and sell human eggs: Russia, India, and the United States. It's illegal in Scandinavia, in Germany, in many other countries, in all countries in Western Europe. Sometimes it happens anyway, people go around the rules. But you have histories that set and people's moral beliefs about themselves and what things should be that may or may not be observed in the breach, as it said. So I think there's still going to be quite a bit of variety. And if anything, we see arguably more religious war in the world, more difference in ideology. And I think that may translate to continuing differences about the moral issues that come up in a lot of these procedures.